Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to make a drop-down list in Excel. To create a drop-down list, you'll need to first decide what items you want in your drop-down list and then type them. This will become your source data. In this example, we'll create a list with yes, no, and maybe. You can type the items in the same worksheet in which your drop-down list will be in, but my preference is to type them in a different worksheet and later hide that worksheet. I think doing it this way helps the document look cleaner. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. So let's go back to sheet 1 so that we can insert our list. We'll just highlight a few cells to add dropdowns to, and keep in mind that if you later want to add more cells, you can just copy and paste this over. Then go to the Data tab, and in the Data Tools section, select Data Validation and select Data Validation again. In the Settings tab where it says Allow, select List and make sure that In Cell Dropdown is checked off, because otherwise you won't see the dropdown arrows. And for Source, I'll go back to Sheet 2 and select the items that I type for our list. This will create a drop-down list that limits inputs to the choices that you selected in your source. What this means is that a user will be able to choose an item from the drop-down or type the exact item that is on the list. If they try to type something else, they'll receive an error message. You can go to the Error Alert tab if you want to customize or edit this error message. The Input Message tab allows you to add a note or message that users will see whenever they place their cursor on your list. But try to use this sparingly, as it can cover up the cell and I think make it a bit cumbersome for the end user. Once you're done, click OK and your list should be ready. To test it, go to where you placed your list. The down arrow should reflect all of your option choices. And you can go to a different cell that's part of that list and you'll see that they each contain the same down arrow with the same choices. To add or delete options from your drop-down list, make the changes on your source data. If you need to, you can always go back to Data Validation and edit your source range. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to create a drop-down list in Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks!